After having Wednesday off, Donald Trump is once again back in the courtroom today, and he's probably still a little bit bitter about what happened to him the last time he was sitting in that Manhattan courtroom. Because on Tuesday, during the ongoing jury selection process that was happening that day, Donald Trump was forced to sit in court and be humiliated as the judge and his lawyers read mean tweets about him from prospective jurors. So here's what happened. Trump's lawyers, to their credit, like I'm actually shocked that they did this. They got the names of their prospective jurors. Of course, that's what happens in jury selection. So they went through, they actually did their due diligence. Again, shocked they did this. They went through these people's social media accounts. So anytime they sent out a tweet or did a post on Facebook or any other social media outlet attacking Donald Trump, mocking him or making fun of him, Trump's lawyers took a picture of it, screenshot it, you know, copied the text, whatever, and they had printouts of these things. So when those jurors were being questioned about whether or not you can be impartial, Trump's lawyers said, okay, well, you tweeted out on this day. I don't even want to read them. Some of them are a little bad, but basically they read the mean tweet out loud. The person has to respond to it. But of course, Trump sitting in that courtroom has to hear it. And then there were a couple times when some of the jurors tried to downplay it. And then the judge would be like, no, 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 hold up. You also said this. So the judge is reading the mean tweets. And according to the reporters present in the courtroom, Donald Trump also had printouts of them that he was having to look through at the desk. So he's hearing it. He's seeing it. He's looking at the people who posted it. And it's absolutely a humiliating experience for him that, according to the reporters, he does not look amused at all. So he's sitting there pissed off, seething, hearing these horrible things about him from these people that he's now having eye contact with, and there's nothing he can do about it. Now, of course, these jurors were excused. And again, I am shocked that Trump's lawyers actually did a good job with this. This is what lawyers are supposed to do. And they did it. Like, that is shocking because of how bad we've seen Trump's lawyers in court before. But here's the thing. Trump has managed to surround himself by only being on Truth Social, which is only conservatives over there. He has surrounded himself in his bubble with people who love him for many, many years now. So he has not had to deal with this kind of criticism like he would get on Twitter with the mean people responding to him or on Facebook. He's been oblivious to most of it. And all those years of surrounding himself in his little safe space cocoon came unraveled on Tuesday when not only did he have to see them, but he had to hear other people read them out loud. And he had to look the people in the eyes as their mean tweets about him were read. Yeah, that's a pretty humiliating experience. I wouldn't want to be there. I've seen mean tweets about me, sure. But I damn sure wouldn't want to have to sit in a room as people read those out loud to me with the people who wrote them standing right there. That would be awkward, and it would be very sad. And that's exactly what Trump had to do on Tuesday. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.